P6966, the very first production Whirlwind Mark 1, suffered a burst tyre while taking off in June 1940 while on station in Scotland. The resultant damage rendered the aircraft unable to land. P6966 was abandoned by Pilot Officer McDermott just north of Grangemouth. P6966 struck the ground in a vertical attitude and buried itself some 25 feet into the ground. Substantial pieces were recovered in 1979. Steve Vizard, owner of Airframe Assemblies, was a member of the dig team and retained possession of much of the recovered material from P6966. Being a good friend of both the Whirlwind Fighter Project and the Kent Battle of Britain Museum, Steve has kindly offered loan of the recovered artifacts to be displayed alongside P7056 at the Hawkinge Museum. The recovered pieces are the remains of the port and starboard engines and their accompanying nacelle structures that were dragged deep into the ground behind the Peregrine engines. They are the only known original artifacts from a Whirlwind. The recovered material provides a Whirlwind Fighter Project with a treasure trove of knowledge regarding the structure, materials and construction methods employed by Westland. Sadly, access to this material also illustrates the lack of information and detail that would be required to obtain certification to build a flyable replica. The Whirlwind Fighter Project has now access to extensive reference material to assist us in the continuing build of P7056 to as near as possible a production standard Mark 1 Whirlwind. A significant step forward has been made regarding the gauge thicknesses of materials used. Previously unknown construction and assembly methods employed, along with the material specifications and the forming technologies utilised. As part of the conservation of the recovered pieces, the Whirlwind Fighter Project will undertake both external and, where possible, internal 3D scans to further confirm our existing knowledge and to extend our understanding of how the Whirlwind was constructed. The Whirlwind was not only innovative in its design, but also at the forefront of emerging material sciences and processing technologies. Very little of the exact material specification was listed, as the Whirlwind had been officially declared as top secret. Of particular interest to the project is the material specifications for the extruded section used in the Whirlwind. Extrusion of high-strength aircraft aluminium was in the 1930s a new technology. It will be interesting to establish which of the aluminium alloys, whether that was copper, zinc or silicon, were employed. With future analysis of recovered material, it is hoped that the gaps in the Whirlwind record can now be filled. As the images show, the main spar booms were also very heavy section extrusions, stiffened by aerodynamic struts in the internal radiator bays and a four-layer shear web across the nacelles. These form part of the very heavy box structure that provided the required strength for the twin strut retracting undercarriage and provided the stress continuity from the engine mounting bracket back to the rear spar in place of a more conventional box section wing structure. The Whirlwind fuel tanks were a typical example of Petter's design ideology. They were not part of a wet wing, nor an integral internal tank design. They were of an aerofoil form and simply bolted to the main spar. The inner tank ends were castings that butted up to the nacelles but were not fixed to them. A major discovery for the Whirlwind Fighter project was the investigation of the undercarriage. The rear crux joining the main retracting tubes and the operating jack attachment point was found to be a heavy aluminium casting and not a steel forging as first thought from the only information in the AP manuals. While the Whirlwind Fighter Project and the Kent Battle of Britain Museum are thrilled to have these artifacts to display, they do place an additional financial load on the project. We are as always looking for donations to fund the conservation and display of the only extant remains of a Whirlwind Fighter. The Whirlwind Fighter Project is a not-for-profit charity run by a group of volunteers dedicated to reproducing this iconic World War II fighter. If you feel you could assist the project, please visit the Whirlwind Fighter Project Facebook and web pages. Donations can be made through the Whirlwind Fighter Project's GoFundMe page. Also, please visit our active partner in the project and home of the Whirlwind Fighter aircraft and associated artefacts, the Kent Battle of Britain Museum at Hawkinge. Please subscribe to the updates and many thanks for watching.